picture the New Testament. This podcast covers a resource available in Accordance Bible software. No knowledge of Accordance is required, nor any knowledge of Hebrew or Greek. Ever try to imagine what biblical times were like? Where Jesus walked around Galilee? Or how about how Paul traveled during his missionary journeys? Today, I'd like to introduce you to an exciting new Accordance visual resource. Picture the New Testament. Picture the New Testament, when it's completed, will span the entire New Testament and include more than 1,000 images. This initial release covers the four Gospels, Acts, and 1st and 2nd Peter. The resource will be automatically updated as more books are completed. We can open the resource directly from the library by itself. We can then open and use the table of contents to navigate to the scripture verse we want. Clicking on any thumbnail will open the picture in its own window, giving us a glimpse into the world of the Bible. This photo is of the Mount of Beatitudes overlooking the Sea of Galilee. The Church of the Beatitudes is in the center of the photograph. A single photo like this can make a Bible passage seem more real, whether it's for ourselves, our Bible study class, or a congregation. Illuminating a biblical passage. A better way to use this resource is to open it in a parallel pane, as shown here. That way, the resource and its illustrations scroll with the Bible passage. It can do that because Picture the New Testament is a photo commentary, a reference tool, unlike the alphabetically organized photo guides and photo museum. This passage is entitled Jesus Heals a Leper. It appears in Matthew 8:1-4. Let's see what this resource has to offer for this short pericope. We'll untie scrolling on this pane so the passage will stay in place. We'll also dismiss the info pane and instant details to give us a bit more room. The first article on this passage is on the place where the events of it took place, the mountain where Jesus taught. There are two photographs in it and a brief description. We've already seen the first photo. Here's the second one. The second article is on the leper that Jesus healed. It's illustrated with a mosaic from a church in what was once Constantinople. Sadly, the mosaic has been damaged over the years, so the faces of what are presumably Jesus and his disciples are no longer visible. The third article, also on leprosy, simply points back to the earlier article. This is one of the ways we've tried to keep the size of this resource small. If a term is repeated within the same pericope, the article on it and the image aren't repeated. Now, if the term appears in a different passage, it is repeated, so we don't have to jump around in the resource to complete our study on the passage. The fourth and fifth articles are both different from the others. Neither is about a character in the story, but a person referred to in the story. The first is a priest. Jesus tells the former leper to go and show himself to the priest as the law commanded. The article here also cites the relevant Mosaic passage, Leviticus 14:1-32. The fifth article is on Moses, as Jesus also mentions him. Here the article offers us two pictures, one of a famous statue of Moses, the other of a painting. Since both images show Moses with horns, the article goes on to explain that the images were both based on the Vulgate's depiction of Moses in Exodus 34. The horns are meant to represent power. So what images does Picture the New Testament offer us for this gospel story? First, we have two photos of the location. We also have one for the leper in the story and the priest to whom Jesus sent him. Finally, we have two pictures of Moses. Now, let's imagine we were trying to prepare a Bible study or a sermon at the last minute, complete with pictures. These would be the choices we'd have at our fingertips. These will work. My only regret is that they didn't include a picture of Jesus, or Jesus and his disciples, though those are easy enough to find. Illustrated reading of Scripture. Let's use this resource in a different way, as a source for visual illustrations while reading Scripture. We'll use just the graphics provided from this photo commentary on this passage. Here's the story of the sower and the seed from Mark 4. And again he began to teach beside the sea. And a very large crowd gathered about him, so that he got into a boat and sat in it on the sea. And the whole crowd was beside the sea on the land. And he was teaching them many things in parables. And in his teaching he said to them, "Listen, "Behold, a sower went out to sow. And as he sowed, some seed fell along the path, and the birds came and devoured it. Other seed fell on rocky ground, where it did not have much soil, and immediately it sprang up, since it had no depth of soil. And when the sun rose, it was scorched, and since it had no root, it withered away. Other seed fell among the thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked it, and it yielded no grain. And other seeds fell into good soil, and produced grain, growing up and increasing and yielding 30-fold and 60-fold and 100-fold. And he said, he who has ears to hear, let him hear." More features. There are several other features in this resource we haven't yet covered. Since both of the previous passages have been from the Gospels, let's look at an example from Acts. Consider this article on the chariot mentioned at Acts 8:28. The picture here is of an Egyptian chariot, which is appropriate since the passage is about the Ethiopian eunuch. The other feature I mentioned is the hypertext links to visual resources with more information and more pictures. The first link in this article is on chariot racing. It appears in the Photo Museum 2. The second is a bit less relevant, but still useful. It points to an article on King Tut, which in turn gives us some early cultural background on Egypt, a kingdom that often included Ethiopia. A lot of us have so many visual resources, we forget what we have. For us, picture the New Testament as an index to visual resources we already own, offering relevant links for each passage's people, places, and objects. Picture the New Testament also includes maps, one more feature. The intended audience of 1 Peter includes people spread over a very wide area in Asia Minor. Here, we have a short article on each place, a hyperlink to its photo guide article with more pictures, other verse references that mention that place, and a map with the location highlighted in red. Picture the New Testament is a great graphics resource, whether we're studying a passage, teaching a Bible story, or just reading scripture. If you'd like to be able to visualize Bible passages, consider adding it to your Accordance library today. This has been Dr. J for Accordance Bible Software. Thank you for watching this episode of Lighting the Lamp.